The objective of this lecture is to continue with our link, and at the end of this lecture you'll be able to tell what is a model, how to fill a generic list, and how to use order by clause against a list. We shall do all this using entity model. We shall fill a complex list and execute an order by query against it. So we'll start it this way. Let me revise what we did the last time. We created a home controller, and inside the home controller we had an index action which returned get data. Get data was a function that returned a string. We had this query, we had this data source, then we had this query, then it was executed, a string builder was filled and a string returned to the index, which was finally displayed on the screen. Today we shall, instead of acting on a string array, we shall act on a model, a list consisting of model objects. So let us first of all try to understand what is a model. Model is any C# class that consists of related properties. The properties are related. For example, I can have a class CStudentData. This class can contain properties which are related to student data. One property could be like, these are all public, I'm writing P here, public string name get set. So you might not be knowing this, and in case you don't know this, then I'll tell you this one. This is public. The visibility of this property is public. I have just abbreviated it for P dot, otherwise it is complete public here. The type of the property is string, the name of the property is name, and there is a shorthand notation, curly brace, get semicolon, set semicolon. This means that this property is read and write. Many people do not write this one. They simply write property like this, public string name and semicolon. In some scenarios this works, but this horribly fails in certain cases, and you cannot even know the reason for this failure. Very subtle bugs they arise because people simply skip this get set. Always be in a habit of putting a property with get set and make it public. Don't forget this. People forget this also, and then they don't find it in the IntelliSense. So CStudentData is a model class if it contains only properties that are related to this concept. Another property could be like public string roll number, again get set, marks in maths, marks in physics. So all these related properties, when put in a class, The class is called a model. Take another example of model. Another example could be class C doctor, and we can write, so a doctor has three properties: public string email gets it, public int rating gets it, public string speciality gets it. C doctor is a model. And these are three properties of that model. They are public, get set. Models in MVC. All model classes should be put inside a folder called models. They should be put inside a folder called models. And MVC Visual Studio knows it. So when you create a basic MVC app, it automatically creates a folder called models for you. Have a look here. Solution Explorer, and a models folder is already there. So we'll add a model to this now. Right click, add class, and we are now creating a class C student data. Click add. So where did we click it? We clicked on the models folder, and this file is added inside the folder, and there is a class called public class C student data. Let us add a property, add properties to it one by one. Public string name get set. So as you type, it automatically aligns also. So you can simply take it as an indicator that you have done it correctly, and that is why it has formatted. Another property, public bool knows MVC get set. Public int marks get set. So this is our model on which we'll operate. Get set, data type, name of the property, and this is the model. Since all these properties are related to one entity, C student data, it is called a model. C student data is a model, and these are the three properties. Okay. Coming back to our home controller, let us erase what we were doing earlier, remove it. But in your case, I would recommend you should start a new project and then reach this point. In our case, we shall fill a generic list with few data and then return a string by querying it and then display it on the screen. So basically, I have to change the contents of the getData function. Okay. So first objective, as I told you in the last lecture, is to obtain the data source. In this case, the data source is list angle bracket C student data. So when you type, it won't appear here first time, because C student data is inside some other namespace. You are here and C student data is here. So as usual, right click and an option to resolve appears, and you can click this one. When you do this one, then a line is added at the top using my MVC application dot models. So it adds a namespace there. So we can create its object ls is equal to new list. So this is an empty generic list that can hold C student data objects. This is a generic list that will hold objects of C student data. Now let us add the first object. We'll use the C# syntax for this. It might be new for you, so follow it quickly. ls dot add, close the bracket simultaneously. I opened the bracket and closed it also. Many people, they start writing and then they think of closing it. No, always match the brackets. When you open, close it simultaneously. Add. So here we'll create an object of C student data. New space, then you can press control space together. It will show the IntelliSense. And we can also type C student data. It is new C student data. Open and close the bracket simultaneously. Start a curly bracket. Enter the curly bracket and you should see this one. I'll explain it. Here, ls.add. We are going to add an object to ls. So add function has been called. This is the opening bracket and this is the closing bracket. Inside it we have written new C student data and curly braces are put here. These curly brackets are used to set properties quickly. This is the recommended way nowadays. Use curly braces to set the properties quickly. Okay. I'll enter here. Make one more enter to make space. Now at this point, you should push space bar once. I'm doing now space bar. The moment I press the space bar, I find three properties available here. These are the public properties. In case you forgot to make them public there, they won't appear here. Okay, the first one I double click it. Write equal to, and I can write hoven. This is one property that I have set. Set the other property by writing comma. This syntax is very important if you want to succeed in MVC. A lot many things can be done inline quickly because of this. I put comma, again space. Again I pushed the space bar. And here you see the remaining two properties are now left. I can double click on knows MVC and put it equal to true. Then comma, again space, and the last one is left, and I can write marks is equal to 98. I can then format it. Control push the control key down, with the control key down, type K, and with the control key still down, type D. Control down, then tap K, then tap D, then release control. It will format it. You can also go through the edit menu. This is format document. It is also control KD. It is called control plus K comma control plus D. It is basically control KD followed by this. Format the document and you get this one. So one element added, and now let me again add another element. I'll add ls dot add, open close the brackets, put the semicolon, new C student data, it's round brackets, enter curly, control KD, it's formatted. And now I'll give the first property space name is equal to company comma knows MVC is equal to false comma marks is equal to 89. Control KD. So I have added two objects to that list, and I'm being a bit smarter now. I'll just copy paste it quickly, but you should actually type, practice it out. I'll write name India, knows dot knows MVC, yes it knows MVC, and marks are 56. Okay, control KD. So our first step is to obtain the collection. LS is available. Second step, write the query. Query is equal to ls dot where, write the generic here. It is a collection of what? It is a collection of C student data. LS is a collection of C student data, and where is being applied against it? Dot where, condition is x goes to x dot, x will be a reference to C student data, x dot marks more than 60. This is the condition. I want to chain it, I want to sort it also. So I can chain this query, that is put a full stop here. I can chain it. Order by, again, what type of collection is it? This. And in these round brackets, I'll put x goes, and what is the key against which? It has to be T key also. If you see the intelligence that appears here, it has to act on a, there has to be type of the column which is to be ordered by. So I'm writing order by, C student data is the type of the collection, but second column is the data type of the column on which you are ordering it. So we shall be ordering it by the name of the student. So I'm writing string. So it is the second template argument that I have to give. Now I can write x goes to x dot name. I'll just put it like this. So this is so that it's clear. I'm putting enters here. This is, I'm just formatting it. It's better it is done this way. Okay. This is ls.where, this is acting on C student data, and you are writing the condition here which is true or false. For whatever records this is true, they'll appear, otherwise they won't appear. Then I'm putting dot. So whatever appears, that is ordered by, first argument must always be the type of the collection on which you are acting. The second is the data type of the key on which you want to order. I am writing x goes to x.name. I am ordering on name. Had I ordered on marks, I would have written x goes to x.marks, and here it would have been int. Okay, our query is in place. By the way, if you wanted to get it ordered by descending, then there is a function available for this, dot order by descending. You can have a look it here. So it is order by descending. So we are ordering it by ascending. So okay, our query is available now. Lastly, let us execute it. So to store the results, I'll write string builder sv is equal to new string builder, and I can now execute it. For each c student data, remember that this is a collection of, query will return a collection of c student data objects. This query will ultimately return a subset of ls. That is, it will contain C student data objects only. For each C student data CSD in query, then we are writing a format expression here. So I'll write sb dot append format, and I'm writing 0 this. So I'm writing name is equal to 0, marks is equal to 1 and comma, and here I'm writing as usual hr to put our horizontal row, and I'll write csd dot name comma csd dot marks. So you can have a look at the complete expression here. Name is 0, so this one will come here. This is a hyphen, marks is equal to 1, and this one will come here. And HR will be just a horizontal row from the HTML. This query is a collection of CSD objects, and we are accessing each of them in the for each loop. Okay, now having done that, return sp.to string. Okay, see all the steps. Create a collection. Write the query. Here we write the query. And execute. You can chain the query where and order by are chained, and you could do even more chainings also. So it's rather easy if you compare it with ADO.NET. That would have required so much of junk code for you. Open con, do this. Here you don't have to do all that. Now let us execute it. When we run it, the results of get data will flow here and will ultimately move to the screen. Running it now. Here is the output. Name is company hyphen marks is 89 HR. Name is oven marks is 98 HR. So this is ordered ascending on name, C and HR ascending order. Okay, now I'll give you some exercise. So the question is, create a model called C doctor data with properties name and rating. name will be a string and rating will be an int. Then you should create a list of C doctor data objects. You should create a list of C doctor data objects and add objects to it one by one. Finally, display those doctors who have rating more than 5. So you should try this exercise and see that you follow all the conventions. Thanks.